The same study is a phase 3 study that compares for the first time monotherapy of a BTK inhibitor, the acalabrutinib, versus what is kind of standard therapies in CLL, which is either idelalisib plus rituximab or bendamustine plus rituximab in the relapsed refractory setting. And the study that we presented here at EHA show that indeed acalabrutinib monotherapy is much more effective than these established therapies. So progression-free survival, the median progression-free survival was not reached after 16 months, while instead the other two drugs, either two drugs, had a median PFS of around 16 months. The interesting point that after 1 year, 88% of the patients still did not progress, while instead 69 progressed when treated either with idelalisib plus rituximab or bendamustine plus rituximab. On top of this, as we expected, somehow acalabrutinib showed a very well tolerated profile, so less adverse events, the typical adverse events that you would expect from a BTK inhibition were present, but at a lower frequency. So we had much less bleeding and atrial fibrillation. We believe that this is a therapy that hopefully in the future may become another option for the treatment of patients with CLL.